Blessed are the peacemakers, they shall be called the children of God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Jesus said to his disciples, "As the Father loves me, so I also love you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy might be in you and your joy might be complete. This is my commandment. Love one another as I love you." The Gospel of the Lord.
Thank you for coming to the cathedral this evening for this holy hour of prayer for peace in our communities. The Catholic Church throughout our nation is observing today as a national day of prayer in the wake of tensions and some violence and race-related strife in communities throughout our country these past several months. So we pray this evening for peace and reconciliation, for justice and solidarity, for unity and cooperation, and of course for an end to violence. This past Sunday, we rejoiced that Mother Teresa of Calcutta was canonized a saint. And Saint Teresa once wrote, "Today, if we have no peace, it is because we have forgotten that we belong to each other." There's a lot of wisdom in that. If we have no peace, it's because we've forgotten that we belong to each other. In so many of our communities, particularly those where there is racial tension, we must remember that we belong to each other. You know, there are bitter divisions in our country. I think of the divisive politics that we encounter today, the bitterness, the lack of civility in public discourse and political debate. We have forgotten that we belong to each other, that we are brothers and sisters in this human family. Every person is created in the image of God. And it seems that the way some speak about those they disagree with, or the way people sometimes treat their neighbors of a different race or ethnic group, reveals a failure to see the image of God in their neighbor. As Christians, we believe that every person has a transcendent dignity as a creature made in God's image. But how often this dignity is ignored, it's forgotten, or it's rejected. The dignity of the unborn child, the dignity of the undocumented immigrant, the dignity of prisoners, the dignity of the poor. Senseless violence in neighborhoods, certain neighborhoods, right here in Fort Wayne, often drug related. I think all this reveals a forgetfulness, not only of human dignity, but also a forgetfulness of God. The great majority of Americans profess that they believe in God. But sadly, many live and act as if God did not exist. When this happens, human dignity disappears. The bishops of the United States chose today, September 9th, for this day of prayer because today is the feast of Saint Peter Claver, the patron saint of racial justice. For 44 years, this amazing Jesuit missionary priest cared for the spiritual and physical welfare of hundreds of thousands of African slaves brought to Colombia, South America, in the 1600s. At that time, many of the white people considered the slaves to be less than human. And Saint Peter Claver devoted his life to their service. And he was despised for this. And for a time, the authorities even prohibited him from baptizing the African slaves. You know, every month in Cartagena, Colombia, 1,000 enslaved Africans were unloaded from the boats. Can you imagine that? And they'd be in those ships, those slave ships, many of them very sick, some dying, covered with sores, and terrified, you know, taken from their homes, homeland, brought to an area they didn't know what was going to happen to them. And St. Peter Claver would get in a little boat and go out to the ships, and he'd get on board, and he would try to calm their fears. And then when they were unloaded and put on the slave market in Cartagena, he was there to help them as much as he could. He was their advocate. He was their defender. They would try to separate families, and he would work to keep the African families together so that the children wouldn't be separated from the parents. But he did all this because he saw in each and every face of the African slave the image of God. He saw Christ in the face of every slave. Like Mother Teresa, centuries later, who saw Christ in what she called the distressing disguise of the poor. St. Peter Claver spent 44 years as a priest there, tending the sick, bringing food, and just caring for them, showing them the love of God. And Peter Claver would reproach the slave owners for their brutality, so he wasn't a very popular priest. We ask for his intercession today as we pray for racial justice, for peace, and for respect for the God-given dignity of every human person. We heard in the gospel reading the heart, the very heart of the moral teaching of Jesus Christ. It's one simple commandment: love one another as I love you. And this divine love appears most radiantly in the cross, where Jesus lays down his life in an act of perfect love. Our Lord requires that his disciples practice the same kind of radical self-giving love. The visible sign of our love for Jesus, the sign that we are truly his disciples, his friends, is our obedience to his command to love one another. And the Holy Eucharist, which we adore, the true body and blood of Christ, is the sacrament of love, the sacrament of charity, which nourishes us and strengthens us to love one another as he has loved us. It is the Eucharist that strengthened St. Peter Claver in his heroic work as the slave of the slaves. It was the Eucharist that strengthened Mother Teresa. You know, an interviewer once asked Mother Teresa how she could go out into the streets tending the poor and the dying. The interviewer said, these people, there's a stench, they have these terrible diseases, aren't you worried? They're contagious, they're awful to behold. And Mother Teresa replied, every morning I participate in Mass and I spend an hour in Eucharistic adoration, gazing at Jesus. If I can see Jesus in a little piece of bread, in the sacred host, how can I not see Jesus in the face of those who are suffering, in the face of the poor? And that's true. We see Jesus right now, right here in the Eucharist, his sacramental presence. And when we leave here, we must see him in our neighbors, especially those who are hurting and those who are poor and in need. So let us remember as we continue our prayer the words of Saint Teresa of Calcutta as we pray for peace in our communities. Today, if we have no peace, it is because we have forgotten that we belong to each other. And let us remember the heroic example of Saint Peter Claver. May these two great saints intercede for us and for our communities. The Litany of the Sacred Heart of Jesus. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. God, the Father of heaven. God, the Son, Redeemer of the world. God, the Holy Spirit. Holy Trinity, one God. Heart of Jesus, Son of the Eternal Father. Heart of Jesus, formed by the Holy Spirit in the womb of the Virgin Mother. Heart of Jesus, one with the Eternal Word. Heart of Jesus, infinite majesty. Heart of Jesus, holy temple of God. Heart of Jesus, tabernacle of the Most High. Heart of Jesus, house of God and gate of heaven. Heart of Jesus, aflame with love for us. Heart of Jesus, source of justice and love. Heart of Jesus, full of goodness and love. Heart of Jesus, wellspring of all virtue. Heart of Jesus, worthy of all praise. Heart of Jesus, King and center of all hearts. Heart of Jesus, treasure house of wisdom and knowledge. Heart of Jesus, in whom there dwells the fullness of God. Heart of Jesus, in whom the Father is well pleased. Heart of Jesus, from whose fullness we have all received. Heart of Jesus, desire of the eternal hills. Heart of Jesus, patient and full of mercy. Heart of Jesus, generous to all who turn to you. Heart of Jesus, fountain of life and holiness. Heart of Jesus, atonement for our sins. Heart of Jesus, overwhelmed with insults. Heart of Jesus, broken for our sins. Heart of Jesus, obedient even to death. Heart of Jesus, pierced by a lance. Heart of Jesus, source of all consolation. Heart of Jesus, our life and resurrection. Heart of Jesus, our peace and reconciliation. Heart of Jesus, victim of our sins. Heart of Jesus, salvation of all who trust in you. Heart of Jesus, hope of all who die in you. Heart of Jesus, delight of all the saints. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Jesus, gentle and humble of heart. Let us pray. Father, we rejoice in the gifts of love we have received from the heart of Jesus, your Son. Open our hearts to share his life and continue to bless us with his love. We ask this in the name of Jesus, the Lord.
Salus honor virtus quoque
sit et benedictio precedenti ab utroque comparsit laudatio.
You have given them bread from heaven. Let us pray. O God, who in this wonderful sacrament have left us a memorial of your passion, grant us, we pray, so to revere the sacred mysteries of your body and blood, that we may always experience in ourselves the fruits of your redemption, who live and reign with God the Father in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
The divine praises. Blessed be God, blessed be his holy name. Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Blessed be his most sacred heart. Blessed be his most precious blood. Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar. Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete. Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary Most Holy. Blessed be her holy and immaculate conception. Blessed be her glorious assumption. Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother. Blessed be Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse. Blessed be God in his angels.
Christ and none other.
in the Father, glory to God on high. Christ is the world's peace, Christ and none other. No one can serve him and despise another. As unites us, one in God the Father, glory to God on high. Christ is the world's life, Christ and none other. Sold for the silver, murdered our brother. He who redeems us reigns with God the Father. Glory to God on high. Spirit, Son, and Father, give.